my name is Bob Luther, and I teach trumpet at REW Music. I fell in love with playing the trumpet because when I was a kid, there was no music in my family. I was, you know, just a kid who joined band in sixth grade. And I remember very distinctly that when I was young, I fell in love with practicing. And I was standing in line at a music shop, not unlike REW Music, and I saw the trumpets up on the wall behind the counter, and I had this thought cross my mind, which was, I never really thought it before. I said, you know, if I practice this thing, I think I could get pretty good at it. And as a seventh grader, I had been okay at the trumpet, but when I actually started practicing, that's when things started to turn the corner for me. And the other thing that happened at the same time was I started listening to music. I started listening to jazz music, and then later on, classical music, and that really changed things for me. That made me really love music. I actually had an amazing experience receiving a lesson. This was something that happened to me a few years ago, actually. It was during my doctorate, and I had the fortune to go down and just take a lesson with a professor at his house, and I ended up, we ended up hanging out all day playing the trumpet, and it was incredible because he was so generous with his time. And one of his philosophies and the things that we talked about a lot and that I try to bring into my own studio of trumpet players is the sense of family, that we're all working together and we're all here for each other. And that's really important to me as a trumpet player, is that we're all part of the same brass family. And so if you study with me, that's something that we're really gonna cultivate, is a feeling that we're really a part of the same team. A great success story in my studio happened when a few of my students, my former students actually, decided to get together and compete for the National Trumpet Competition a few years ago. And they, I wrote a piece of music for them, and it was just because we wanted to do it for fun. And they had created this high school division, so they were all just high schoolers. And we put this piece together, we sent in a submission, and they got accepted to the semifinals. So we went to Kentucky and they competed in the semifinals, and they ended up making the finals and they got third. And so it was pretty incredible because they had never, you know, really done that together before. That's something that was a really special experience. And being their teacher, I just felt gratitude to be able to have been a part of something so special. And they can keep that experience with them for the rest of their lives. But most importantly, they had that team experience of really working together and having a communal experience with music. That's really important to me. For the concert etude, some of the challenges that you'll face, the most prominent one is the double tonguing. This piece requires you to double tongue very, very frequently. And if you don't know what double tonguing is when we're using the front and the back of the tongue in quick succession. So we're saying, instead of what normal articulation is on the trumpet, like a two syllable with the air, we're going two, coo, two, coo, two a lot of times. So it's going back and forth. And this is something that takes quite a bit of practice to be able to master. I can't stress enough that you're not gonna start doing this fast. What you wanna do is you wanna start with just a G in the staff or some kind of a middle note, doing simple two, 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 and then moving to a coo syllable, which is the back of the tongue. It's gonna feel strange the first time you do it. Coo, 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 coo. But then eventually, two, coo, two, coo, and feeling the different action, but trying to make them sound the same. The more that you do this, the better it's gonna get. And you can start to get short bursts of speed after a little while. Another thing that's a pitfall in this piece is the phrasing and the endurance. We're changing styles. Generally, this is very technical or technique oriented at the beginning of the piece. And then as we get into the middle part of the piece, it becomes much more lyrical in character. And so to be able to differentiate those styles, we don't just want to play in the technical, we want to be able to shift into that more beautiful sounding lyrical style. That's going to make a big difference when you play this for Allstate.